Welcome to my channel, A Creates, the channel for online tutorials and more information about game design. In this video, I'm going to show you some simple tricks in Game Maker to understand how to initiate your own objects and spawn those at randomly on the screen. As a start, we are just going to create one object, so which is in this case the sprite of the Pikachu. Import the sprite of the Pikachu and you're ready to go. You need to create the object of the Pikachu as well, because a sprite this is basically only the sprite image. So we create the object of the Pikachu. We want to create an object that will spawn the Pikachu, so we create the object. Name it object spawn and don't assign any sprites. We can just make the create event and immediately assign the create instance and do that every single time for every Pikachu that we want. But we are not going to do that. We are going to give it a bit more manual behavior. So I'm not going to do this, but in this way you can do it. I'm first going to create an alarm. So let's drag in the alarm. This will mean that after like around 200 to 1000 steps, this is going to activate alarm 0. And in that case, we are going to create Pikachu. So we are going to create the object and we will set the random value again. So random x value 0, because the 0 of the end, and 1366, because that is the size of the room. And the random I value 0, 7. Great, this will create a Pikachu at a random location. We want to restart the alarm itself, so restart itself, and we took 200 plus random 1000, and in the Pikachu we want to set a create, set an alarm after 300 steps. After 300 steps we want to set the alarm and tell itself to destroy itself. You can do this method in every object single and changing the alarm, but I'm going to also show you a different way of making objects, or in this case drawing sprites. To explain this method, I'm going to take the sprites from the most common Pokemons that you will see around Pikachu, which is of course Metabot. Brings me back to those days that I played Pokemon, and that every time Metabot was around, as well as Weedle and Rattata. Or these Pokemons were just totally annoying. I just remember those Pokemon to be the most annoying for my playthroughs to Pokemon. You can add any Pokemon in this line. Just remember that Game Maker counts from 0, and then 1, 2, and then 3, 4, and so on. And now we want to create an object which chooses one of the Pokemon, so object show Pokemon. And now we will give it a create event and we will assign the variable of Pokemon. And we will give it a value of choose. Choose is a function in Game Maker, so choose x1, x2, x3. So in this case, like 0, 1, and 2. And we will give it as well a countdown, because we want to have it jumping around. So alarm 0 will be 100, random 500. And don't forget what I did the plus. Next, we will drag in the jump to points, which you can just find by the toolbox as well. And we are going to say random range 0, 3, 6, 6, and random range 0. And we are going to copy this event, paste it, and give it the alarm. Alarm 0, because alarm 0 is doing the same. So now every time when an alarm is called, it will change the Pokemon value into one of the three Pokemons. So we're going to use it to draw the sprite. So we drag in this draw sprite, we choose the sprite, we set the position on relative, and we choose the frame of the chosen Pokemon. So now we just create an object that will always change the Pokemon from itself and to a random position, but it doesn't generate itself. So we go back to the spawn object, so double click on the spawn object, and we will drag a new alarm in. Just be aware to change the alarm, like alarm number 1, and we are going to give this faster countdown, so random 200, and then add events alarm 1. And in this alarm we will drag in the create instance, object show Pokemon, and doesn't matter where it ends, and just restart the alarm. So 100 plus random 200. And don't forget to click alarm 1 to the countdown. Okay, so now basically we have every single time there will be new added show Pokemon object. but this will cluster our field, and normally with Pokemon there are sometimes a lot of Pokemon, sometimes not, and so on. So we want to have another alarm as well. Next step will be in the create event. Oh, this is not correct. I think I just made a mistake by setting, yes, I set the alarm countdown in alarm zero. So I'm just going to copy it and just going to place it in the create event. Oh, that's a bit stupid. Anyway, we are going to the create event and going to drag in the other alarm.
We need to have a bit of a nice value. I had before a very like high value, which makes like spawning Pokemon all the way.
So I'm just going to say 200 random 100. No, that's the same as alarm 1.
So you can find out what. If you don't like to forget the values, just copy the alarm 2 and just set it in the new alarm. Paste, and we are going to destroy the show Pokemon. Okay, the only thing to do now is to open the room, dragging object spawn. Press S5 or press on the run button to run your game. And you would have created something like this. You can always tweak the numbers. Just remember that it's going to be tweaking to see what kind of feel you want. Learn a lot in this lesson. We have initiate objects and draw sprites at randomly with alarms. Let me know if you like this tutorial, and next week I'm going to show you how to make a nice walking sprite animation in Game Maker in drag and drop. Enjoy your week. This is A Create. Create more. Enjoy more.